Roger.
Hey, no broken legs this trip.
I think they all stayed inside this weekend and talked about skiing.
Too cold skiing.
Yeah, it's colder up here than it's ever been.
Conductor to engine 3011.
Highball, Holly.
All right, Jim. All aboard. Let's get going.
Never get used to it, Ben. Never get tired of it.
Hi, Green.
Hi, Green. Now, how's a fella supposed to retire and say goodbye to that country? Did I tell you I was gonna retire?
Yep. Yes, you did, Holly.
Did you know I was 65?
Yep. Yes, I did, Holly.
65 tomorrow.
Your interest.
Oh, it's more than interest. It's desire, passion. Your name is,
Ellen Staffo. Mrs. Mr. Staffo is standing over there at the bar. And I guess that's the end of that.
It's too bad.
What am I missing?
Well, we were going to be great lovers, you and I. We would have gone to Monaco, where I'd have made a killing at the tables. Would have lived in Capri.
And all on my credit cards, right? Hope I didn't spoil your day.
No, I feel lucky.
John, the way you came down those slopes. Next time you got to look.
Really?
Who was that?
Did you see my fall?
Nobody.
Have you thought of what we're going to say to him?
What?
What are we going to say to the kids?
Your mom and dad love you, but they can't stand each other. So they're getting a divorce. Please choose up sides.
Look, I could be glib, too. But in an hour, we're going to face him. Now, what are you going to say to him?
I can't think now. I'm on Capri.
Join the session.
You want the music department, not history.
Hey, Mr. Dunn. Sweater's dynamite. Love it.
My wife made it for me.
It's very sexy. I mean, for a professor.
Here. Now, how come nobody's studying the Hundred Years' War, huh?
You wouldn't single me out like that. Why don't you go and join the others?
I love you.
Don't do that.
You think they can read your lips?
Please don't.
I just need to know how you feel about me. I really need to. Go ahead. They can't read your lips.
I'll call you when I can.
Hey, Bob. Hey, Mark. What's the matter? Here.
My ticket.
Conductor?
Hey, wait a minute. Hey, come on. Give me a break, huh?
What's wrong?
Oh, you're with that group over there, aren't you? You're one ticket short.
Oh, it's mine. I didn't buy one.
That'll be six even.
You can ride for free. Come on, man. You got to use your head. What's the railroad to you, a friend? Take
it. No, thanks.
Hey!
I could stay on the last 70, you know.
Then I'd lose that supplemental pension. An incentive, they call it, to retire at 65. Now, you know Bill Travers.
He and I's been engineers for almost 40 years. He's planning on retiring next month and buying himself a farm. Wants me to go in partners with him on it. What do you think? Flashing yellow.
Flashing yellow.
Listen. Listen to that engine. I've been riding this engine for over 10 years and I've learned its language.
Bill Travers, now, he can't wait to make his last run on that brand new engine we got.
You seen it?
No.
It's got a lot more power. And I'll bet it's a lot quieter, too. Of course, that's the trouble. I don't talk to you.
What's she saying to you now, Holly?
Right now, it's saying the tracks are icy. And I'm gonna break her just a mite. Ah, 10 pounds of air doesn't even slow us at all. I'll give her 10 more. Hang on. I'm gonna stop the train.
To dispatcher.
Go ahead, ski special.
Dick, this is Holly. I'm having trouble with my brakes. No air going through the brake line. I can't reach the conductor, so I'm sending my fireman back.
Okay, Holly, we copy.
We'll try the emergency brakes and the coaches. If that doesn't work, we'll try the handbrake. And if that doesn't work, by God, we got us a runaway coming off this mountain.
I got you, Holly. Dispatch it to the work train. If you still have any equipment on the main line, get it off now.
We still got some carving to do. How does it look?
Just get it off now.
favors. I don't need them.
What do you need?
Just me.
Good for you.
Watch it. Sorry. Look, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
So don't say it.
Dad, I just couldn't do it.
I understand.
You don't. I know you don't.
I do understand. Makes me worry about you, that's all. All last summer, we talked about climbing that mountain. We got there.
And I got scared. Scared, I admit it. And yesterday, I was scared to ski with you, too. I just looked down that slope and I couldn't do it. And I don't want to, Dad. I'm sorry.
Look, I know about fear. You think I don't? Fear is something that comes up every day. Sometimes it's a decision at work. Sometimes it's a person trying to hassle you. And sometimes it's a mountain. Whatever it is, you have to face it and beat it.
Dad, some people are scared to go out on a stage and face an audience. I'm not.
With you, everything is fantasy. Plays you do at school, the things you talk about. This is real. Out there, that's what you have to be. Mark, I'm not mad at you. I'm not. I just want to try and help you.
Holly, the work train's off the main line.
Oh, Bob, emergency.
Now hang on, Holly, and just keep talking to us.
What do we got?
Ski train, no brakes.
That's a 3% grade all the way down. Who's on it?
Holly Gibson with a crew of four. 214 passengers.
I think maybe we ought to start off by telling him why we went away this week. To think it over. And we thought it over.
And the marriage is thereby canceled, revoked, nullified. Mommy and Daddy don't give a damn anymore. Except about their children.
Well, you're not very much help.
Are finally facing facts. It's over between them, so they want to end it now and say goodbye. Don't we? End it now and say goodbye. Romances. Grown old and passed away.
Romance?
Well, what do you want to call it?
What?
Dear kids, your father and I are now arguing about what it is we're always arguing about. I say it's we don't love each other anymore. And he says...
He says... Doesn't look like either one of us have much left. Nothing to give. I guess it's saying what you're saying.
Dear kids, your father and I finally agree on one thing. Divorce.
Sorry, excuse me.
All right. Come on, pick it up.
Holly, Holly, this is Jim. What's going on up there?
Down. All right.
What?
fast. We just burned out the emergency.
What is he saying?
I don't know.
Who is this sound?
Now, what's going on?
Nothing.
I hear some nothing.
We got no brakes, no air pressure. We just burned out the emergency.
No brakes?
I've always got an idea. We're going to try the handbrakes. But we've got to work fast.
What'd you say?
Gentlemen, we're going to need your help.
Well, come on, show us what to do. We've got a problem, but we're going to take care of it. I'll be right back.
They need me to work a handbrake. They got to stop the train.
Why?
I don't know.
What's going on?
What's happening?
It'll be okay.
You're coming through, please. There's a handbrake like this in the front of every car. We'll listen for the signal, the train whistle. And when the engineer blows it, he'll also release a load of sand on the track. And that's when we start pumping. Up and down. Hard as you can. Okay, up ahead.
You're about ready.
Give me one more minute to get set, will you, Holly?
Okay. What happened?
Herb, you gotta put the emergency to her.
We did, Benny. Burned it out. Now we gotta try the handbrake.
Oh, dear God.
Try now.
There's not much.
Something. There has to be something.
Probably ice in the brake pipe.
Oh, I gotta get back. What does that mean?
Clog of ice holding back the air pressure. Might melt as we go down the mountain. It's a chance.
What else?
The brake pipe's got angle cocks on every car. Maybe one of them's closed, blocking off the air.
Maybe.
I checked them before we started. They were open.
Let's check them again.
On a moving train and there's ice out there.
I'm willing to risk it. How about you?
Well, you can't do it alone.
Tell you all what to do, right?
Oh, we're all gonna die.
Look, don't panic. You understand? All right, look, take everything
o'clock. You hold on to me. Don't slip.
Right.
Is on the floor. The engineer will radio me when we approach a curve, and I'll tell you and all the people in the other cars. Now, it might just be that the engine will go off, and we'll uncouple and stay on the tracks. We have a very good chance of coming through this without anybody getting hurt. So let's go to work.
Your track all the way home.
Appreciate that, Dick.
But you won't make it past the curb at Arvada. What's your speed?
55. And you know something, Dick? We might just ride that curb.
Not at 55, you won't. Now, Holly, Bob is getting ambulances and fire equipment out to that curve. Now, we put you there in 8 minutes.
You girls help the man get all the glasses and bottles down off the bar. Anything that might fly around in here in case we derail. And you, can you help me pull the shades down over these windows? We've got to keep the glass from coming out of here.
You pull the shades.
What?
It's your train.
Now look, mister, I need your help. We could go off this track at any minute, right?
Right, so?
So I'm going to be ready. I'm going to make it. You run around and pull the shades, not me.
Ben. You know what I was just thinking?
Oh, Holly, what?
I've been crazy about railroads since I was 8 years old. 57 years, Ben. 57 years. When I was a kid, we lived on a farm. My dad had an old white workhorse. I used to ride that old white horse down the trackside every day.
Every time a train would come by, that old horse would stampede and try to run off.
He never did get used to that train, but I did. I've always been crazy about railroading.
Ollie, don't you know what's going on here? Don't you know what's going to happen to us? Well, don't you care?
Room, kid.
Look, go back to your seat. Grab your coat or anything else soft and put it around you.
I've never been in a train crash before either. So what? You still gotta use your head. You gotta use your instincts. You gotta land on your feet.
Remember now, everybody stay flat on the floor. 4 minutes, so get ready.
Everybody, so grab hold and brace yourselves.
Ready now. Ready.
Now what? Come on, what's in front of us?
Holly, how did you ever stay on that track at 55 miles an hour?
It was 62, Bob, and I guess we're coming all the way home.
Yeah, I'm afraid you are, Holly. There's nothing to stop you. Nothing between you and us.
Yeah, Bob.
Next stop. Jackson City Station.
God help us.
Holly.
Yeah, Bob.
Holly, we're evacuating the station. The fire trucks and ambulances will be standing by. Look, Holly, is there any chance of your locating the problem?
I figure it's ice in the line, Bob. Temperatures are lower up here than they've ever been. But it might be a closed angle cock. I got my brakeman checking it now.
Well, good luck to you.
Appreciate that, Bob.
Attention, please. Attention. We have a runaway train heading toward the station on this dead-end track. Please evacuate this area immediately. All passengers and all personnel must evacuate this area immediately.
Whose idea was it to go away to the mountains for the weekend?
Yours. I wanted to go to the beach, remember?
The one good idea, the right idea you had in your life, and I wouldn't listen.
Now listen, everybody. There's nothing ahead of us now but the station at Jackson City. And that's a dead end. We hope we can stop the train before we get there. But if we can't, that's where we're going to hit. Now, if you'll get ready, brace yourselves, we've got a chance. So stay on the floor and protect yourselves.
What a way to finish our weekend.
What a way to finish.
No, no, I don't want it to finish. Not for us, Liz.
I don't either. I'd take it all back. Stop the trip.
Down from the sea. You're gonna be killed there. Don't! Stop it! Please, somebody make him stop! Stop it! Please!
Hush, shut up! Can't somebody shut her up?
Stop!
with him?
He's dead. He fell into the train. The angle cocks are all open. I guess he was right. There must be ice in the line. And we've got one chance to beat this thing, and we're going to take it.
Look, there's nothing we can do.
Look, the kid will be safe here.
Safe? This train's going to crash, buddy. Well, we don't have to ride on it.
To go through that stop, then the baggage room.
But what's beyond it?
Waiting room. We're clear up on the other now.
What do you want, my people?
The street with the fire equipment.
Back over here.
Marth could jackknife all over this place. No telling.
promised me you wouldn't single me out like this. Why don't you go and join the others?
I love you.
Please don't.
Hiya, Mark.
What was his name?
What?
The brakeman. What was his name?
Herb. Herb Elcott.
Did he have a family?
He had a wife. Sorry. Skate has some.
I know. Me too. I'd like to go be scared with my husband. Will you be all right?
Yes.
I was thinking if we could just maybe jot something down to the kids. Just you put something on the paper and in case. Then you can put the note in your purse and they'd probably find it. What do you think?
I think that's good.
The only thing is I haven't written a word. I just keep thinking about the other time I yelled at him. And then time I spanked Jason, which was, what, 12 years ago. I want to tell him I'm sorry. I don't know.
We can just tell him we love him.
Yeah, look, here we are. Again, wondering what shall we say to the kids.
You all right? Yeah, here. Let's put this against the seat, okay? In about 15 minutes, we're going to hit that station, but we have a chance to make it if we get back inside there.
You go.
You want to die?
Yes.
Listen, a guy just got killed trying to stop this train. What do you want to do? Just throw it all away?
What difference does it make? We're all going to die.
All right, if you believe that, come on, come on, come on, back with me inside there.
No, I won't want to be alone with it.
With what?
Leave me alone with it. Leave me alone.
Hey, I owe you some money. Listen, hey, I know I said that, but well, I say a lot of things. You know, I'm good at talking, but I don't always know what it means. I don't know. Yeah, just kind of say it to get me through. Hey, listen. There were people on this train who really needed me. I helped them. Do you understand? I really did. I helped them, and that's important.
I don't want to be helped. So go away.
I want to stay with you.
Time we got, Holly?
Holly, what are you thinking about?
Horses. Wild horses.
What?
Horses, Ben. Horses.
Bob, are you there?
Yes, Holly?
That brand new engine we got. The one Travers been waiting for? What's the horsepower on that thing?
It's 3,500. My God, Holly, I know what you're thinking.
That thing ready to roll yet?
3,081, and I mean this minute.
Dispatcher to Yardmaster. Is Track 19 cleared out of the yard?
3,081. It has to be ready.
If she can catch us, she can stop us. Hey, is Bill Travers around?
Put old Bill on her. If anybody can catch us, he can.
You think he can catch us, Holly?
Well, I don't know, but I figure we'll chance it.
It's all clear, Bob. The unit will clear the yard in 4 minutes.
That'll give them another 4 minutes to get into position. We'll put the new engine on this siding. When the ski train passes, this engine will come out onto the main track and chase it. It'll try to catch it, couple onto the last car and apply the brakes before the ski train hits the station.
Piling in on our wreck. Tell him that.
Right.
You remember Bill Travers, Ben? He's the one buying that farm. I still haven't made up my mind to be his partner yet. What do you think?
You know, when I saw you, I knew you were going to give me trouble. You know, I just knew you were going to drive me crazy. First, you pay my way, and then... Wait a minute, please. Please, I won't come any closer, I promise. Hey, you know what? We can decide. If we can decide not to die. You know how? We'll make a date tonight. I would like to take you out to dinner tonight. 8 o'clock. Or 7:30. Boy, I'll pick you up. Oh, no, wait a minute. Boy, I'll meet you there. Hey, if we make a date, we can't die, right? Answer me. What's your name? Please, what's your name? We should be seeing him any second now, Bill.
Yeah. But we'll hear him first. Get ready, Bill Travers. We're coming home.
Dear children, we're just a few...
Put their names down.
Dear Laura and Jason, we're just a few minutes from the station. And we know what's going to happen. We love you so much. And that...
helps. Helps us.
Yeah. 9 minutes. 9 minutes. Hold on to something.
And that helps us now. It really does. Jason, I'm sorry I got mad about the fender. I'm sorry. Fathers and sons, stop hugging each other. We'd like to hug you both. Right now. Laura.
Mom.
Forgot to tell you lately. Your dance is beautiful.
We love you. We love each other.
And we love each other. Yeah. We're both sorry.
Dispatcher. 5 minutes. We've got to clear the area.
It's like falling.
It's like what?
It's like falling through space. It's the same thing, only it's taking longer. We have time to think about it.
Hey, we're not falling.
We're falling through space. I don't want to think anymore.
Hey, wait, Joe, please, please, Joe. Here we are, date, remember, 7:30?
Why?
Because I don't want to eat alone tonight. Because I want you to be there. Because I want to know your name. Because I want to see you laugh. Hey, I want to take you to Giorgio's Cafe. Giorgio's Cafe has a singing waiter. Well, it's Giorgio, really, and he's also the cook. He's a terrible singer. He's rotten, but he's a great cook and one of the last of the singing waiters. What do you say? I really want to know you. Please, I really want to know your name.
the junction. I'm coming in and he can't catch me. So call him off, you hear?
Holly?
Bob, call him off.
Travers, he's too close to the station. Give it up.
Travers, apply your brakes, do you hear me?
Thank you.
thinking about that farm of yours. Wish you a lot of luck on it. I believe I'll stick around for another five. I've definitely made up my mind. So you take it easy and take care of yourself. See you.
Well, that's fantastic. That's just beautiful. Hey, I'd like you to meet Carol. Her name is Carol.
Hello, Carol.
Hello.
Oh, Carol, that's great. I love it.
To the dispatcher. I stopped a little bit short of my spot, and I'm 23 minutes ahead of schedule. How do you like that for making time? Thank you, Joe. Be seated.
Stars in the Rockford Files tonight at 10, followed by the Sunday 11 p.m. movie. Now, stay tuned for the latest edition of Primetime News coming up next on Channel 9.